Where do you live? In Africa? Asia? Australia? Europe? Or North or South America? Or even if you found a place to lodge on Antarctica? We all know one another, and know that there are 7 continents in the world. Some say it's 6 if we combine Europe and Asia together as Eurasia, because after all, they are one solid landmass. And some say 5 that consider one Eurasian and one American continent. The most widely accepted view, however, is that there are 7 continents. And that's what you were probably taught growing up. But how many of us are aware of the so-called lost continents, Mu and Lemuria? Mu and Lemuria were postulated in the 19th century by a writer and explorer, Augustus Le Plongeon, and later through the writing of James Churchward, and some people even today believe in it. These 2 continents are different and yet similar in ways, and some believers and also non-believers say that they may have been the one and the same. Mu might have been a misinterpretation of stories of Lemuria, but in both cases, they are said to have been destroyed and sunk beneath the ocean. Mu was said to have been destroyed, Atlantis-style, in a catastrophe, while some parts of Lemuria had sunk and others remain. According to Le Plongeon's work, Mu was located in the Atlantic Ocean, while his successor, Churchward, believed it was positioned in the Pacific Ocean, between Easter Island and the Marianas, if we go from west to east, and Mangaia and Hawaii if we go from north to south. This idea was first introduced by Le Plongeon after his extensive exploration of the Mayan ruins in the Yucatan region. He translated ancient Mayan writings at the site, but these translations were based on a misinterpretation of an ancient pre-Columbian Mayan book, the Troano Codex. Charles Edien Brasseur de Bourbourg, who was the original translator, tried to decode the glyphs in the book but found limited success. It had been said that he translated a word in the codex as Mu, referring to a land which was submerged by a natural disaster. Le Plongeon was hooked by de Bourbourg's speculation about the Maya and their connection with Atlantis and began on his journey to solve the mystery of the lost Mu. Le Plongeon continued to interpret the writings based on the idea that the Mayan civilization was older than the Egyptian or Greek civilizations. His research led him to conclude that when the continent sank, a survivor of the disaster, which would be Queen Mu, founded the Egyptian civilization, while the other survivors reached Central America and became the Mayan people. If there really were another continent, more countries, more people, more cultures, it would definitely interest all of us to find out more about it. And that's what happened to James Churchward, who was an author, engineer, and inventor. He even believed he had a preternatural ability to understand the symbols from ancient cultures. He wrote about the lost continent of Mu from 1926 to 1933, moving the location of Mu from the Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean. Churchward's fascination increased when he met a priest at an Indian temple while he was posted there as a soldier, who showed him clay tablets which were allegedly from the Mu. The tablets were written in the Naga Maya language, the language of an ancient Tibetan people. From what he learned from the priest at the temple, he went on to describe Mu as an advanced civilization named Nakal, who existed between 50 to 12,000 years ago. Churchward also claims to have translated another Niven tablet. From his interpretations of the tablet, he estimated that there must have been 64 million inhabitants living in large cities. He also suggested that Mu was formed when underground volcanic gases pushed the landmass above sea level. Lastly, he claims that the continent was destroyed in a single night by a series of earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. With continued extensive research, he entertained the belief that all megalithic artwork originated from the Mu. He linked the Egyptian god Ra with the king of Mu, who he claimed was named Ra. But hold on there, something smells. As a matter of fact, it reeks. It reeks like the smell of a writer trying to sell his books. Points to be mentioned, Churchward's whole story have quite a few holes in it. No one had ever seen this tablet that he mentions that the priest showed him. And as for the Niven tablets, they were discovered by William Niven, an archaeologist, among 2,500 stone tablets, but they were unintelligible, even to experienced archaeologists. No one had ever translated them, and he was said to have made drawings of the tablet and then having reburied them. And then they were eventually lost, so no one can translate them anymore. Looks like Churchward is turning out to be a hoax. Although Churchward seems to be one smelly author, a few individuals did follow in his footsteps, with William Scott Elliot and James Bramwell. Bramwell believed the last major cataclysmic event was that of the Mu continent. Then, in the early 20th century, Ataturk, the founder of the Turkish Republic, thought that the Turkish homeland may have originated out of the Mu. Then another, Masaki Kimura, a professor at the University of Rukias, claimed that some structures off the coast of Yonaguni Island in Japan were possibly the ruins of Mu. As for those who believe in a Lemuria, the idea began with Philip Sclater, who found lemur fossils existed on Madagascar and India, but not along the logical route that a land primate would take between the two. So Sclater came to the conclusion that Africa and India were connected by a large continent. This theory soon spread, and people found more supposed reasons to support the claim. As you can see, Sclater seems to have been looking for an explanation to something he couldn't understand. Unlike Churchward, at least this guy's theory was based on some science. Excited to know what the Mu people were like? Unfortunately, with geographical knowledge and plate tectonics, modern science completely discounts the existence of Mu. The Earth's crust is made up of Sial rocks, forming the upper continental crust, which floats on a heavier Sima rocks, which forms the lower oceanic crust. It would be impossible for a whole continent to sink into the ocean, at least not in a single night, or as a matter of fact, not even in a few hundred years. What is possible is that the shape of the continent could change, or the position could be changed due to continental drift. But scientists explain that this phenomenon takes place over hundreds of millions of years. Moreover, scientists were unable to find any trace of cataclysmic event on the ocean floor to prove the existence of a missing continent. And when it comes to the lemur fossils of Lemuria, it can be explained by plate tectonics, when Earth's plates move continents towards and away from each other. So there could be similar land animal remains in two parts of the world separated by water. And lastly, after recently deciphering the Troano Codex, the text actually appears to provide information on astrology. So you can say, due to this one error led by Lei Plongeon and Bourbourg in interpreting the information in the first place, led the imagination of so many people go wild. The mystery of the sunken island and its advanced civilization certainly proved too tempting for the explorers who took up the mantle. Feeling down? Don't be. Even if the Mu or Lemuria might not have existed, I'll introduce you to a continent that might have. It is called Zealandia. In a study done by GSA, a group of scientists had done a 10-year research to prove that Zealandia was geologically its own continent. This discovery, however, was made in 1995. A geophysicist named Bruce Lewendick came up with the term Zealandia to describe New Zealand and New Caledonia and other submerged pieces of crust as part of a southeastern edge of the Gondwana supercontinent that separated from Australia many millions of years ago. This breakup stretched, thinned, and distorted Zealandia, lowering the region below sea level. The study states that New Zealand and New Caledonia are the two islands that are the highest points of Zealandia. Researchers have looked at the diversity of igneous, metamorphic, and sedimentary rocks, the height differences relative to the ocean floor, and recent satellite-based elevations and gravity maps to find that the region did appear unified. In 2017, geologists from New Zealand, New Caledonia, and Australia concluded that Zealandia fulfills all the requirements to be considered a drowned continent. So there you go. There might not have been a Mu or a Lemuria, but there was once a Zealandia. But of course, we will still tell the tale of the people of Mu, because folktales are just more interesting and more entertaining than boring old facts, right?